I'm Adrian from AWS.
And I'm Apsar from Infinitium. This is my architecture.
Apsar, thanks for joining us today. So you're in the online payments industry. What does that entail?
Thank you, Adrian. At Infinitium, we serve more than 180 million card users specifically for online e-commerce transactions. And one of the biggest challenges that we face is fraud.
Let's dive in.
Absolutely. So we have this authentication system that we are integrating our fraud detection system with. So during the payment authentication flow, the fraud detection kicks in. We have Amazon CloudFront because our customers are throughout the region. AWS WAFs helps us be secure against many common vulnerabilities. From the CloudFront, the requests are routed to our load balancer that helps us upkeeping with the scalability aspects of it, which goes all the way to our ECS cluster.
Right, this is where the brains of the system is. Now, I understand you had version 1.0. What were some of the challenges you were trying to overcome?
Yes, 1.0 had been an on-premises solution that was difficult to scale. And one key consideration was that the 1.0 had standard transactional parameters, while for our enhanced rule processing, we needed to have enhanced metrics around those rules. So we are talking about more than 290 rules that we now support with FDF 2.0.
Okay, so how do you actually deploy those containers into the environment?
Right, so we have the development process where all our microservices are in separate repositories and they go through a CI/CD process, which then gets those containers deployed into ECR. And that's where our ECS cluster pulls them from.
Great, so you have all your images sitting up there. So you could have chosen lots of different compute classes. Why did you choose AWS Fargate?
We are a small, humble team. And the last thing that we wanted to do was manually maintain the systems and deployments. So we decided to just focus on the development process and getting the product out in the market, while Fargate helped us host those services without the need to essentially actively patch or maintain the deploys.
Also using Graviton instances, right?
Yes, we are, because that's what provides us a better price performance ratio.
So I see you using also lots of different data services here, and I see Amazon Neptune, a graph database. What are you using that for?
Yes, so Neptune helps us manage more complexities of the transaction. Because in your traditional transaction, you have multiple components. So you have transaction information, your user information, your device information, these are interconnected. This makes one set of transaction. Now, with Graph, we don't only look at this particular transaction, but also the historic anecdotes of this transaction, for example, the velocity of this card or things that, of a historic nature. And with Graph database, we are able to traverse in depth with comparatively better latency as compared with other databases.
So Graph is a lot more efficient when it comes to this sort of complexity and dependency structure that you have, right?
It is. So while Graph helps us get into extended transactional insights, it's also important to use the technology that's fit for the purpose. Mm. So while Neptune helps us look at those insights, we also use DocumentDB to store our policies, our rules. And at times, we also flatten this information into DocumentDB for different purposes.
Amazon RDS, how are you using that?
So while we have all of this contemporary functionalities that are looking into transition insights or managing the policies and rules, we also have the traditional functionality of providing some of the interfacing through a CMS to manage this information, so organization data and user data. And that traditional information is then capped over the RDS.
So obviously this whole system needs a lot of low latency processing, Amazon Memory DB. How are you using that?
Exactly. So while all these systems are very good at what they do, Memory DB with Redis is also providing us microsecond latency in different aspects. For example, one of them being we have our microservices here that are being authenticated by an authentication service. But once they are, once those are authenticated, we save the authentication information in Redis, and that helps us process the subsequent requests very fast.
So Absa, you're in a regulated environment. How has this actually helped you deliver?
With FDS, we also had to be PCI DSS compliant, and a lot of services we noticed were compliance ready, and that kind of helped us go to market much faster.
Yeah, so AWS has taken care of all that for you. Fantastic. Absa, thank you for sharing your architecture with us.